I've always been a very kind of visual doodler and taking lots of doodles normally when I wasn't really paying attention in class. During my PhD, when I was going to conferences, there's kind of this rise of social media during conferences and people tweeting at the talks they were going to. And I realized that, especially when using a digital tablet, that it's very, very easy to share the notes I was taking as an image on social media. When I'm sketchnoting, I use a digital tablet. And normally the evening before, I start by trying to write out the title of the talk and also the name of the speaker. Those are the two things. Those are the only two bits of preparation I do at all for a talk. So you don't need to do anything else. And then I normally add a bit of color just to make it a bit more visually appealing. And then normally as soon as the talk starts, I try to get a quick kind of gestural sketch of the speaker to try and capture the kind of the pose that they're doing. And often the speaker moves around a lot during the talk, so you try and think of what's a pose they're probably going to keep coming back to. So either gesturing towards the screen or facing the audience. But sometimes you get speakers who just don't face the audience at all, so you just draw the back of their head. And then as that's going on, that's kind of the tricky bit, is throughout the talk, I try and switch between the kind of quiet moments, downtime in the talk, where I can go back to drawing the speaker, and then try and actually get the content down. So normally the first minute is quite important for getting the introduction, what the talk is about, and then trying to put some visuals in, particularly if they have figures, those are great, or kind of anything graphical you try and latch onto. Maybe a few bullet points about what they're talking about, and then I'll go back now, instead of with a pencil, with a pen, to try and kind of do an overview of the speaker again. And then again, once I've done the pen overview, I go to the colors. And then I normally have some pre-saved colors for different common skin tones that you can put in. That saves a bit of time. You can mix any color you want here, but it does help to have a palette ready to save time. And then there's a lot of different tools one can use for very quickly blocking in large pieces of color that helps. And then if there's like a minute left at the end, you can try and make things a bit better arranged. So there's like cut and paste tools where you can move things around to try and give it a bit more of a coherent look. But again, at least my style, it's never looking very clean. I kind of like it being a little bit messy and chaotic. And then once that's done, you're ready just to take it to social media and share it. I think if anyone's interested in getting into sketchnoting, you shouldn't be worried if you don't have any artistic training or you don't think you're a born natural artist. It's not really about trying to do a really detailed oil painting. Just try and summarize the things in the talk that you're interested in. Focus on the key elements of a talk, the take-home messages in a way. Try and make something that I think has to be fun to do, otherwise you're not going to do it. So something that's appealing and enjoyable.